Welcome to Belgium, a country famous for many things. Delicious handmade chocolate. The award-winning combination of chips and mayonnaise. Beer. Very strong beer, brewed by Max. Many, many famous racing drivers. Jackie Ickx, 6 times winner at Le Mans. Thierry Boutsen, 3 times a Grand Prix winner for Williams. The list is absolutely endless. Oh yes, and there is one other thing. One of the greatest racetracks in the world. If, as an endurance racing team, you're looking to test yourself, and I mean really test yourself, then this place ticks all the boxes. Every last drop of your skill, your levels of concentration, and your resolve will be pushed to the limits. Things will go wrong, things will break. You'll need to react, change your plan, fix it quickly, and get back out there. No sleep, no let-up. Drive fast, but drive with your brains. And hope everybody else does the same. Heartbreak is always just around the corner. But if somehow you make it to the finish, that sense of achievement will live with you forever. This is 25-hour racing. Welcome to Spa.
Each year, thousands of spectators come to witness this unique event. The grid is split into 3 classes, Evo 1 for 1.8-litre petrol engines, Evo 2 for diesels, and Evo 3 for the powerful 2-litre cars.
Drums. Graham, first time here. What do you make of it so far?
Oh, it's been a fantastic experience so far, Chris. The amount of people that say, oh, you've got to drive these kind of circuits like Spa and Le Mans and other places, but you do have to really drive because they are fantastic. It's such great fun out there.
What is it about the place that makes it different to and better than other circuits?
The length of the circuit obviously is a key factor, and also the different types of corners you get. You don't get corners like Eau Rouge anywhere else. And you see on TV so many times saying it's always higher than you see on TV. It really is. It's a good, I don't know, say 6 stories high. We've got 100 cars for the race this year, which is monumental, at least 3 times as many as we have in the UK. Skill level is a bit varied, so you've got people at the sharp end and people a little bit away from it, but there's definitely always someone to battle with.
One of the experienced drivers returning to Spa is Mark Burton, who finished 3rd in last year's UK Championship.
Mark, good for you to be back here after a year away.
Yeah.
Bet you can't wait to get going, can you?
No, it should be a fantastic event. Now this is my 5th time I've done this. I didn't join last year, regretted every hour whilst I was watching it on a timing screen from home. Not the place to do it, so really good to be back.
It's so hard to do well here, so hard just to get to the finish, isn't it? So is that part of the attraction of it?
Well, I think firstly it's the teamwork that's required to get the car, the drivers, everyone to the finish. I think that makes it special. The atmosphere is fantastic. And then you need a lot of luck on your side and keep the pace consistent all the way through. The fuel strategy is critical. We don't have fuel gauges in the cars, so the pit wall has got to monitor every single lap and calculate how much fuel they think is left in the car. Push that as much as you can so that you do as few stops as you can. And that's probably the, you know, in terms of pit wall strategy, that's the main thing.
Team Tiger have an outstanding record as three-time class winners of the 25-hour race.
Well, we're back again. This is a circuit where you've got lots of happy memories. You must love coming back here.
We do. This is our ninth time here at Spa, so fingers crossed for a good result.
Why is it so good? Why do you like coming back here?
It's brilliant. Like, the track's brilliant, the scenery's great, the atmosphere's buzzing, you know, it's just, like you said, it holds a lot of good memories for us, so fingers crossed we can create more this weekend.
Just about the toughest race you can do though, isn't it?
It is, yeah, particularly in this heat. I think it must be well over 30 degrees today, and when you're in there for an hour and a half, perhaps 2 hours stints, you know, you get so dehydrated, tired, and you really need the concentrations up there just so you can keep on the track, really.
And it's tough mentally, isn't it, in terms of trying to switch yourself back on and off, because you come in the car, you have all the adrenaline, then you have a bit of a rest, then you're back out again.
Yeah, it is difficult to get downtime, really, because you've just come out of the car for maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours. You really want to sort of get a drink, have a bit to eat, sort of lie down. But all you can hear is the cars going round, and you're thinking, how's the team doing? And, you know, you set your alarm, just try and get a little bit of sleep, but then before you know it, your alarm's gone off, and, you know, you've perhaps not had any sleep at all.
Let's take a look at the UK teams we'll be following here at Spa. Although it's entered as a UK team, Team USA features an international driver lineup. Mark Lawman and father and son duo John and Daniel Coyle joined by two American GT racers. Drivers from different teams often join forces at Spa. Run by Track Talk, the Two-Ren Dominoes team sees regulars Chris Hart and Henry Dawes joined by Mark Burton, who normally races against them in the UK. The CXC Global Racing Team features four debutants: Australian father and son Dave and Dylan Thomas, Neil Plimmer from Team Honeywell, and Guy Wenham from Team Geometric. Also making their Spa debut are Team Trumans. Having cut their teeth in the UK Championship for the last couple of seasons, Colin Kingsnorth, Richard Webb, Julian Bricknell and Jonathan Hode are ready for their biggest challenge yet. Global Racing finished second in class here last year. Team regular Sarah Reader is joined by 2008 British GT champion John Barnes with Mark Farmer and Aaron Head. Addison Racing make their Spa debut and contest the Evo 2 diesel class. Bill Addison and his sons Martin and Rob joined by former Caterham champion Graham Fenimore. Having taken their third class victory last year, Team Tiger know exactly what it takes to succeed here. Regular trio Ben Baton, Chloe Noyce and Ollie Bryant joined by GT and historic sports car racer Will Platt. JPR Uvio features a strong team lineup. Outright 25-hour winner Paul Rose and UK race victors Neil Primrose, Graham Roberts and Fakini Diot, the latter looking to make up for an incident in the early stages of last year's race. Finally, CCS Media, one of the most experienced 25-hour racing teams in the Fun Cup. Bob Tomlinson, Alan Honnemand, Ciro Carinanti, joined by Steve Burns, Steve Johansson and three-time UK champion Nigel Greensaw.
One of the most exciting things about the Spa 25 hours is being on the grid before the start of the race. There are nearly 100 cars to something like 500 drivers, and now they're almost ready to go and get this race underway. Let's go and catch up with some of the guys before they get the race started. Fakini, ciao, buongiorno. All good? Tense?
It's good. It's good.
Are you excited? There's a bit of pressure being starter driver, isn't there? Are your teammates being kind? Are they putting more pressure on you, or are they being all right?
No.
What's your plan for the race, Fakini?
Go fast.
Be safe, though, yeah?
Who cares?
Better start than last year?
Couldn't be worse.
the accent's slipping. You had a bit of trouble last year.
Yeah, you got my Achilles heel, didn't you, then? Yeah, hopefully we can stay out of trouble. It's all right. We're in a tough part of the grid, I think, because we had a lucky qualifying and we got ourselves into a good position. But we're right in the middle of a lot of faster cars. I think the first run up the hill, we just got to stay out of the way. I might just pull on the grass and let them all go because they're going to be flying past. So we'll see. This is about staying out of trouble. Just keep reasonably consistent and keep going round. That's all we have to do. But it's so difficult to keep it in one piece because there are some crazies here. That's why I picked three of them on my team, because they can't bump into me. But yeah,
he's a good team though. You got a decent lineup. You must be a little bit confident, I reckon.
We've been confident before. You need a good set of drivers, and we've got that. But you have to stay clean, and you've got to look after the car. It's not about ultimate lap time. It's about just looking after it so it doesn't break and don't bump into anything. So we see. It's great.
Good luck. Stay safe. Enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. See you in the bar on Sunday.
Oh, yeah. Cheers. Have a good one. Good luck, yeah?
Thank you.
Nigel, hello, quick word.
Oh,
how are you going?
Fine, thanks, Chris. How are you?
Not quite where you want to be on the grid, but you had a bit of traffic, didn't you, yesterday in qualifying?
Well, the biggest issue was the golf this morning. We were playing crazy golf, and Nicky whipped the whole team. So I've got to try and recover from that at the moment, trying to get back into the zone at the moment.
The traffic's one of the frustrations of this race, isn't it? You have to be really patient at this one.
Oh, it's not a frustration. It adds to the fun. It's brilliant. It's a little bit more tricky now with the Evo 3s and the Evo 2s, because the pace difference is quite interesting, but it adds to the fun of it, that's for sure.
Yeah, they're going to leave you on the straights, but you'll catch them in the corners, presumably.
Well, that's the idea, yeah. If we had a driver with talent in the car, I'm sure we would.
One of the nice things about this event is that normally rivals in the UK Championship, you're racing with them this year in this event.
Exactly, it's brilliant. It's a good way of doing motorsport. Yeah, I wish more championships would do it.
Well, good luck, enjoy it, and I hope you have a good run. You've got a good team here, so it should go well, shouldn't it?
It should be fantastic. Thanks, Chris.
Guy, we didn't know you were going to come to this one. That was a fairly late thing to put together, but yeah. I bet you're glad you did.
Yeah, about this time last week, I think it was, when Mr. Plimmer gave me the call, say he was going along, you know, that sort of swayed it a little bit. And yeah, found some money together, so brought it along. Yeah, brilliant.
Living up to expectations so far?
Oh, Eau Rouge is speechless. You can't describe it. No words to describe Eau Rouge. And yeah, the rest of the track is absolutely brilliant as well. You wouldn't find one of these in the UK.
Being on the grid's great as well, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I can't believe how many people are out actually here to watch, you know, as fans. People actually really live the atmosphere of the festival and everything, so yeah, really good.
You're used to starting races, you're used to racing Fun Cup, you've been quick, you've had some good results, but this is a bit different, is it? Are you feeling any nerves at all, or are you okay?
Oh, absolutely. Every race I start nervous. Yeah. But, you know, Snetterson gave me a massive confidence boost. 19th to 5th in two laps was pretty good. But I'm just out of the way of everyone. I've got Evo 3 cars behind me who are quicker down the straight, quite a lot quicker. So I'm just out of the way of everyone and run my own race, bring it in one piece after 2 hours, see what we do.
So the scene is set, we're almost ready to go. Coming up after the break, the start of another epic 25-hour race. Welcome back to Spa, where the 25-hour Fun Cup race is about to get underway. Following a one-lap Super Pole shootout between the top 10 teams from qualifying, it's McDonald's Racing who take pole, with Sarsiden sharing row one. Leader Racing and defending champions Allure team make sure that Belgian teams lock out the first four places on the grid, while the French SPI team and former winners Colson Racing complete the top six. So on board with Fakhrini Diot, who's the highest placed Evo 1 car on the grid in 42nd position. Let's get the race underway then. The Belgian flag is waved and it's a terrific start for McDonald's Racing. They romp clear. Second place is going to be Sarsiden, and then from the front row of the grid, Leader Racing team tuck into third place. Allure team in fourth position as they rise up through Eau Rouge for the first time in this mammoth 25-hour race. On board with JPR Rubio then, and a good start for Diot. He's gained one or two places here, flat out up through Radion at the top of Eau Rouge. There is the Addison Racing car, which is contesting the diesel category. The rest of the field still filtering their way over the start-finish line and up Eau Rouge, as down into the chicane for the first time come out race. Leaders, a bit of a lock-up there, and a bit of contact between the leaders, and it looked like 65 Leader Racing went from third to first, and the erstwhile leaders dropping a place or two with a bit of contact there, McDonald's Racing. Huge, huge field of nearly 100 cars coming down then into the chicane. And look at that, the Truman's car flying around the outside of our onboard camera there, which is the black car now in the background. That's Guy Wenham, and also the Global Racing car coming through as well. So three British teams tied together here in the middle of the pack. I think the Addison car's not that far behind them as well. And a place gained there for the Truman's car again. So two or three positions gained on that run down through the chicane. Coming down into Pouhon though, here is our race leader. He's got back in front actually, so it's the 260
car still in the lead of the race, McDonald's, but having a scare up at the chicane earlier on in the race. You're on board now with Nigel Greensall as he fights at the wheel of the CCS Media car. This is the run through this very quick left-hander at Pouhon into the same part of the course come the midfielders now. There is the pale blue car, the powder blue car of Addison Racing, have their first time here at this race, survived so far. Actually, most people have been well behaved for the first half lap or so. And here's another debutant, Guy Wenham, this time gaining a place as he goes into Le Fan, into this right-left chicane here, midway around the lap, closing up to the tail of the global car. And just in front of them is the purple car of Truman's, number 170, and a couple of places ahead, the Tiger car as well. So the four of them all glued together here, looking back from Truman's as it comes under attack now. And again, this is coming under attack from the global racing car. You can see from just behind here with Guy Wenham how close it is. Out wide goes the global car, and he's run out of road and into the gravel trap. He should escape, but he's going to lose half a dozen places as a result. Meanwhile, further up the road, Diotz is the last of the lace breakers here as he goes into the bus stop at the end of lap number one, gaining two positions. So at the end of the first lap of the race, it's the 260 McDonald's car which leads. 65 Leaders Racing dropped down to third place at one point, but is back to second position now. And then in third place, it's the Sosodent car. And also got Colson Racing in the top six, having made a good start to the race. There is Diotz firing one up the inside of La Source into the hairpin. On board with him now. And the first proper run now down to Eau Rouge. Absolutely flat out from here on in for a long, long ride on full throttle at about 120 miles an hour. There's the Truman's car, which has made a fabulous start to the race, gaining another position there and pulling away from a number of the other British competitors, which are also contesting the Evo 1 category. Look how quick they are as they fly up the hill. Careful not to run too wide. There, a glimpse of the 248 car of Nigel Greensall, who won this race a couple of years ago as a class winner with Team Tiger. Races normally in the UK for the Race Logic team, in which he's been a three times champion and leading this year's championship as well. There's a global racing car trying to come back after that moment through the gravel trap. Here are the leaders once again, and this time I think the 65 car Leader Racing drafting past to get the lead of the race. So the top six, seven, eight cars all still glued together in the very early stages of this race. We go on board once again with Guy Wenham, looking back at him now from the Truman's car. There is Guy in the 103 machine, and he's closing up. And there's the orange car of Team Tiger, Ollie Bryant. He's a very, very quick and very experienced historic and GT racer. He's in the mix here, has raced a number of times for Team Tiger over the years and loves this race, one of his favourite events of the year. And he'll just be playing the long game here. He won't be too worried if he loses a place or two in the first 10 minutes of the race. There's the CCS car there on board with Nigel Greensall now, firing one up the inside. It was 283. That's the DRM Motorsport car. It runs wide on the exit to Pouhon. One of the drivers of that silver car is Christoph Danzenberg, who races various historic Formula One machines, including, I think, an ex-Williams, which he's raced over the years. And we go back on board with Truman's into the pits with a problem. That's the 127 Ezio's friend's car. Another car in the pits there is one of the passenger ride cars. Another of them is this purple car just ahead, as around the outside of Team Tiger goes Guy Wenham. Up ahead, kicking up the dust, there is Truman's. This is a brave move from Guy. He's pulled off some terrific overtakes during the course of the year, and that was another one. So gaining confidence. There's the 23 Team USA car. Only had about six cars behind it on the grid, but it survived the early stages of the race. And they'll be looking to move their way up through the order. There's number 19, Colson Racing, which has made quite a few places up at the start of the race. They won this event 2 years ago, won it a number of times. And up into the 30s now is Diotz. So he's gained 10 or 12 positions at the start of the race. Got a very good exit speed there. His car won't have the straight line speed of some of the 2 litre machines around him. There he is to the left of the picture, the black Uvio car. And just behind, you can see Nigel Greensall in the CCS Media car. He's only about two positions back now. So Nigel closing the gap for what effectively is the class lead for the 1.8 litre petrol class. Exiting La Source and riding down over the start finish line once again. There is the third place car, and that's Chris Hart for Traktor Tourette Dominoes. They've had a good season so far. Looking back at one of these passenger cars, they go out in the middle of the race, give passenger rides, but they're still very quick cars with the 2 litre engines. And that was going past the Truman's car. And Guy Wenham trying another brave move around the outside, this time at La Source. There he is, looking back, staring into the eyes of Guy now. And he couldn't be any closer as they go downhill and down towards the foot of Eau Rouge. And now this is super close. He's going to try and squeeze around the outside and brave it out. Here they are, absolutely wheel to wheel. The black car noses in front to gain a position within the class. That's up to fourth in class now, fourth and fifth, these two, within the category.
both got ahead of Team Tiger, which is back in sixth place in class now. Ollie Bryant losing a place or two in the last couple of laps. Global Racing seventh after that trip through the gravel. And the two leaders now beginning to pull away, out-towing each other. They've swapped positions a couple of times. At the moment, it's the 65 leader racing car in the lead. And out of the pits, having been in with an early problem, I'm afraid that's Addison Racing. So an early pit stop for them. So the crowd enjoying hugely hot weather here. It's about 30 degrees. Imagine the temperatures inside the cars for these drivers with all their overalls on and working really hard behind the wheel of the car. Do at least get some long straights here to get a bit of a breather, but it's going to be hard work nonetheless. Ollie Bryant trying to squeeze up the inside of the 3-2-1 car there on the way into Rivage, but also being careful not to cause any damage to the car, given that they've still got 24 hours and 45 minutes of the race to go. Truman's now pulling alongside and passing the two red Domino's car, so that's a place gained, and that's up to third in class now. JPR Uvio continue to lead the UK class, and they also leads the Evo 1 class, but look how close Nigel Greensall is now. He's closed several positions up. There's a long way back on the grid. He was 63rd. The Uvio car was 42nd on the grid. Looking back now from Truman's, the two red Domino's car coming under attack once more from Guy Wenham. So these three, third, fourth and fifth in class, and Guy Wenham gets a toe down the start finish straight. He'll look down the inside on the way into the LaSource hairpin. Here comes the black car, and the CXC Global Racing Machine squeezes through. They've both got ahead of Hart now, so both gaining a position and just outdrafting one another, but also working quite nicely together, the three British cars, and careful not to run into each other. Back into the lead of the race has gone the 260 McDonald's car, having a bit of trouble with one of the back markers there into Rivage. As we start to see cars coming into the pits now for the first round of driver changes and refueling stops. Expect them to go about an hour and a quarter into the race, most people. Global have made their change already. I think Sarah Reed are in the car now, but it's catching up. It's been going quickly for the last 10 or 15 minutes. And there is the Addison Racing car, which had its moment at the start of the race in the pits. And a replay here of a leader. Now, that car's just got into the lead of the race, making a mistake there. The McDonald's car through the bus stop, which will cost them a little time, but no damage to the car. Now we go on board with Evo 1 leader as Fachini Diot comes into the pits. Careful to stick to the pit lane speed limit. Folsom Racing coming in as well, having got up into the top four in the race. Diot comes into the pit box. No refueling at this stage. They go to a separate refueling area, and he's staying in the car. So he's got a double stint as we head for a break.